It's EVO 2004, the final day of the most prolific fighting game tournament in the world. And though no one knew it at the time, two fighting game legends, Justin Wong and Daigo Umehara, are about to make fighting game history when something that was thought to be impossible became known as EVO Moment 37. Still gives me chills. This is one of my favorite fighting game moments of all time, but it's actually even more impressive than meets the eye. Let's chat with some fighting game pros and find out why. First off, it's important to set the stage for 2004 because, after all, fighting games took a long time to get to here from here. You see, fighting games went on a bit of a downswing. As arcades grew less and less popular, the fighting game genre, which gained its popularity almost entirely thanks to arcade cabinets, started to become more and more niche. One of the games that was helping to keep the scene alive was Street Fighter III: Third Strike. There are a number of reasons why so many fighting game fans love Street Fighter 3, but perhaps one of the most notable and the most relevant to this particular story is the parry system, which allows players to risk not blocking in favor of timing a parry in order to completely negate the mitigated amount of damage taken while blocking, while also putting them in a better position to counterattack. In order to parry, one must press the arcade stick towards an opponent within a 6 to 10 frame window of when the attack lands, or 1/10 of a second. And sure, while that's pretty easy for something like a fireball, anything that's multi-hitting and comes out relatively quickly is not so easy. For reference, what you're watching right now is me trying to parry a shoryuken from Ken that hits 3 times. Chun-Li Super hits 17 times.
This was deemed, like, impossible.
That's L.I. Joe, a professional Street Fighter player and just all-around cool dude, who made waves back in 2016 when he was the sole U.S. player in the top 8 during Street Fighter V's debut EVO on ESPN. Like so many other fighting game fans and players, Moment 37 left quite an impression on him, to the point where he vividly remembers the first time he saw it.
I was at 8 on the Break in Dunellen, New Jersey, playing Third Strike, and it was an arcade that had like a pool table in the background. They used to make what they call break steaks. They were just like cheesesteak sort of thing, and they had a computer behind where they were cooking the break steaks, and they were like, yo, Daigo parry Justin Super. I was like, what? That's impossible.
Back in those days, we had no idea how good anybody was.
This is James Chen, fighting game historian and commentator.
There was no online play, and Daigo was just kind of that legend. It was like, oh my god, Daigo the Beast. He's the best. This was one of the first times he was in America, and nobody knew Justin was that good at Third Strike at the time. We all knew he was a good MVC2 player, and so when he started beating Daigo, everybody was like, whoa, what is happening?
I'm like, where is it? And I remember leaning over the table, like trying to see the computer, and I watched the video, and I couldn't believe it.
Of course, no one on Earth knows this clip quite like Justin Wong himself.
Okay, don't do it. Don't do it. Let me change time. Don't do it. Oh, it's over. I think I saw this like a billion times already.
Hindsight is 2020, but another one of the most interesting aspects of this clip is that his decision to use the Chun-Li super here was a good play to make. Daigo was at such a low life that if he had just blocked the super, he would have been defeated by chip damage, and again, the idea of parrying all 17 kicks was thought to be impossible.
We always had like these rumors where like, oh yeah, it's impossible to parry Chun-Li's super. It's a for sure win. You can even hear in the crowd, let's go Justin.
Let's go Justin!
It's one of those things where like, yeah, you know, chip him out, it's over. And then the parry starts happening, and you see me as a kid just trying to mash out, like, cause it's like, I'm thinking like it's an arcade, like side by side. So if I'm like mashing, maybe I can like kind of confuse my opponent or make him mess up, but Daigo kind of got, you know, he had the little cardboard wall, and then that saved him from getting him off his rhythm.
K-O!
it showed me how much more I had to learn to be good at Third Strike. Like I said, it wasn't even comparable to do something like that.
That really cemented the legend of Daigo Umehara. He didn't even end up winning the tournament, which was the funny thing, but no one's ever going to remember that.
But this clip went viral in a time before YouTube even existed, and people who had never been exposed to high-level Street Fighter play now knew what it looked like and how incredible it could be. It's just really inspiring. It shows that sometimes the things you once thought may be impossible can be done.
When Third Strike Online came out for the Xbox 360, they had a trial mode where parry Chun-Li super, right? So they even used a moment to put it in a trial mode sequence, which was pretty cool. This clip has definitely inspired so many people to keep continuing playing fighting games. Everyone started playing Third Strike in America. And I think a lot of people from like around the world started playing Third Strike.
A huge thank you to Justin, James, and Joe for lending their expertise to this video. What's your favorite moment in esports? Let us know in the comments, and for everything else, keep it here on IGN.